Obviously, we start with our stances. Our tackles here are in two-point stances. Okay, they still need to be square with both feet flat on the ground, have the ability to pass set, go ahead, set it, come on back, or to reach block to their left, set it. Both feet are flat on the ground. Our guards need to be square, their hand on the ground, everything pointed forward. They can have a slight tilt right here in their heel so they can order to get both feet flat on the ground. This hand should be able to pick up and put back down without losing their balance. You guys go ahead and stand up. Okay, give me your stance with too much weight forward. A lot of times guys got way too much weight forward, which is gonna help them in the run game. But if you tell them to pick their hand up, go ahead, and they gotta rock forward, they're not gonna be able to kick off the ball and pass protect. So we wanna see them in a balanced stance where that hand can come up and down and no weight changes. Their weight is evenly distributed over both their feet. Go ahead and stand up. Our center's in a squared up stance. We have used the dead ball snap and the traditional snap. Schooley uses a traditional snap, okay? He's gonna bring the ball up when we're gonna be under center in a square with a slight turn. Go ahead, set hit. A slight turn with the quarterback's hands are seated underneath his ass crack right there, okay? From this position, he needs to be able to set right. Come on back. Set left. And obviously block right and block left, okay? Our right guard and right tackle stances are the same as they are on the left side. Our hands on the ground in a balanced stance, both feet are flat on the ground, and then our right tackle's in a two-point stance. Go ahead and get back in your stances, men. We want our guys off the ball as far as they can be. So our guard's helmet's barely gonna break his belt line, and then our tackle's gonna align on the guard. So if you guys get in your stances, you can see how we're off the football. Obviously, in a short yardage situation, go ahead and get into close alignment, okay? We're gonna tighten our splits down, and we're gonna get closer to the ball to fire off if we're gonna run a sneak or we're down in the goal line. But if you go back to your base alignment, a normal alignment, we're a big zone scheme team. So being off the football allows us to take all of the neutral zone, and if I'm a three technique and I'm slanting, just run cut right, walk through it, set hit. There's more space for that slant to happen and us to pick it up. We feel like if we're right on the line of scrimmage, that movement happens right on top of us and we can't pass it off as well in our zone schemes.